my Celeriac Remoulade. Served with silky waves of cured meats, get your mates round and I'll bet there'll be none left by the time they leave.
Everything's gone mad, Miss Celeriac's gone mad. The weather's gone mad. Anyway, this, my friends, is what a supermarket Celeriac looks like. And definitely, I mean, look, the effort went in. This is gonna be lovely seasonal and it's gonna taste beautiful. But yeah, it didn't work this year, but that's growing, right? So look, I'm gonna make a dish called a remoulade. It's a really, really nice salad. It's a French classic. It's a bit like a slaw. It's one of those little recipes where you can turn crunchy vegetables into something really wonderful. So look, let's have a little prep up here. Take the greenery off. Then we've got those little roots here. These are edible. So I'll keep these here for something else. Celeriac's got that lovely sort of celery, mushroomy flavor. And that is really good with hot or cold smoked fish and really good with cured meats. Now, in a minute, one of my friends is turning up who actually specializes in British cured meats, and he's gonna bring a whole bunch of stuff. So that's why I'm making this. If you use a speed peeler, it's super easy. And then I wanna shred them up into matchsticks. So let's get on with the dressing. We're gonna start off with a nice couple of spoons of lovely mayonnaise. And we really wanna flavor this up to be utterly delicious. We'll go salt and pepper for sure. And then we've got some little friends here. Dijon mustard, heaped teaspoon. We're going to use a cornichon, those little pickles. And actually this one that I'm doing now is more kind of nodding towards a classic French style remoulade, but you'll see people use piccalilli. And even if you go to like New Orleans, Louisiana, where there's a kind of French Cajun sort of influence, you'll see them using like paprikas and smoky flavors and they go red. Just take a little teaspoon of capers here. And we'll just run the knife through that. And then here, we've got some anchovies. Just a couple. Don't need much, it's a gesture. Extra virgin olive oil, just to posh up the mayo. Now, you can use a little lemon or vinegar, but I think the lemon's quite nice and fresh. So now the herbs. Chervil's a really good one to grow, by the way. Chives, very, very nice. And some parsley. And then just mix it up. So that is the base for our remoulade. Right, what I want is nice little thin slices of celeriac. Once you've got like 7 or 8 slices, put them together like a pack of cards and just finely slice them like that. And the finer you make it, the more delicate this incredible salad will be. And absolutely, you can use like a box grater and coarsely grate it. Really easy, even easier, but I quite like it when it's delicate like this. People always think of salads being sort of summery, spring, but of course, if you think about coleslaws, like the remoulade, you just want crunchy stuff that's seasonal. It's really nice to know how to turn these things into real elegance. Look at that. I find that lemon juice really brings out the flavor nicely and it keeps the celeriac really white and very beautiful. And then I kind of go from sort of tossing it delicately to almost massaging it. It starts bringing out the natural moisture and making it taste really, really good. Just a little bit of herb on top. Little drizzle of oil. And that is ready and waiting for Matt's incredible cured meats. That with a few bits of lovely toasted bread, and we're good to go. Thanks for coming down. This is very exciting. Can I?
Yeah, open it, yeah.
Go on!
So, I've brought for you a huge selection of our charcuterie. All of this made by ourselves, British meat, in the UK.
Can I try some?
Yeah, tuck in. This is our colour tallow. This has been aged for about 2 years.
Wow. So in that 2 years, what actually happens? You get more complexity of flavour?
Yeah, very similar to what's happening. Do you know when you have a really good cheddar, parmesan, you get those little white crystals, little crunchy bits. Mm. That's exactly what's going on in this piece of meat. That's just that sort of natural like umami just exploding in your mouth. Like.
It's so sweet and the salt is just right.
We've actually taken a lot of inspiration from Italy.
But why would you not, right?
The recipes work, the flavours work. The only thing we can add to their flavour profile is the meat we have in this country. That's what we want to do. That's what British charcuterie is all about.
Look how amazing that remoulade looks with your cured meats. Look at that. Can I do your little plate?
Definitely. I can't wait.
What I love about this is if you took that out at little family gatherings, you know, bonfire night, that is going to be devoured, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it's not going to hang about. Everyone in the family is going to tuck in.
Right, I'm going to give you a wodge of this so you get one of your five fruit and veg a day. Fresh out of the ground, like an hour ago. But you can get them in the supermarkets and they're really good. So there you go.
Oh, it's beautiful. The freshness, the nuttiness is going to go so well with the charcuterie.
Mmm. Crunchy, soft, the little pops of pickle.
You've got a lot of fat within that charcuterie. It has to be there for it to work. So you need that acidity to go with it. But the sort of nutty, full flavour of the celeriac, it's lovely.
Savoury, silky. So good. Next time you go shopping, if you see celeriac, don't walk past it. They're going to look more like this, the big ones. Mine were tiny, but you can't tell they were tiny in there, can you?
They chop up the same.
They tasted delicious. And also, if you see British charcuterie out there, support it, because the more you support it, the better and better it's going to get.
Yeah.
Cheers.